Right now at noon, fighting the flames and making progress. Firefighters now have this huge forest fire in New Jersey, 50% contained. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jim Donovan. The fire has scorched thousands of acres and forced many families from their homes. It's all unfolding in Ocean County near Route 539 in Manchester Township. Our Brandon Goldner is live at the New Jersey Forest Fire Service Base operations in Whiting. Brandon, what's the...
Jim, right now, several major roadways are back open, but some roadways like Horicon Avenue and Beckersville Road remain closed under a police checkpoint. The air is a real smoky atmosphere, real dusty out here. At times, it can be a little bit tough to breathe. I also want to step aside, show you some of these charred trees that are right near the edge of where this fire happened. According to the New Jersey Forest Fire Service, this fire started Tuesday afternoon, has spread to 3,859 acres. It's 50% contained. Firefighters don't expect the perimeter to grow. They say no structures have been affected either in communities or on the joint military base that's nearby here, but they are concerned about the weather today. Take a look at this video shot by the Forest Fire Service last night of this massive wall of flames engulfing dozens of trees. This is what led firefighters to evacuate 70 homes in Manchester Township and 100 homes in Lakehurst overnight. The Forest Fire Service is now allowing people back into their homes as 70 firefighters continue to try to contain these flames.
This fire exhibited extreme fire behavior. We saw a wall of fire, 200-foot flames, raining fire embers. I don't mean to be dramatic, but this was a severe situation that these guys and gals managed to keep in a place and protect lives and property.
Despite the progress that they're making, firefighters say they are concerned about the weather today because of the heat and humidity and the potential to cause these flames to flare up. We're expecting another update from the Forest Fire Service at 3 p.m. today, which you can watch live on CBSPhiladelphia.com. Jim, back to you.
Thank you, Brandon. And